Hello everybody. Okay, so today's Friday and we were going to do a hangout, but I've had a lot of people, you know, I wanted to show today an example of how a lot of people asking me questions, how do you do this, how do you do that, and again, I wanted to spend a good, normally the hangout's about an hour, so I thought, right, okay, Jamie's off on chasing the moon, shall we say, and Tammy's literally building an email campaign, so I thought, why not spend this hour and show you how I do my stuff. And then I made a post today. I set up a campaign completely new, and I want to show you what I did. And you can see I did it, you know, probably 4 hours ago from this video. And now I'm going to show you how I did it and what the results are so far. Eh? It's just literally 4 hours old, so it's. Internet marketing is all about advertising, targeting your advertisements, and capturing those people. And again, I'll walk through exactly how I did it. So, if anybody goes to my Facebook wall, and probably right about now, I've scheduled it as well, just to show off, to go in the Early Birds Facebook group. So when you see this post, I want you guys to go through the system. Just to test it, because I'll show you how it works. So on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever, I've posted this image. Now, I'm going to work through. I go through how it works. So I click the image, and then it'll pop up a landing page. And that's basically all that is a landing page with nothing else on it. Okay. So the image. Who wants some Bitcoin? We can show you how. No information at all about the programmer. It's a generic post, and that's very important. Okay, well, when we're joining, you know, at the minute AdVGO, we're all pushing it mad, and we're posting posts out there for AdVGO and everything else. But later on down the road, you might want to flip that program, or you might, just for a week, just an example, you want to flip the program for a week. You start off, you know, banners are all over the internet, they're all over rev shares, traffic exchanges, ad sites, and what have you. So basically, you want to make yourself a generic banner. People put in the email address. So I'm going to I'll put mine in, no spamming. And we'll go through how it's actually working there. So they'll pop the email address in there. And the conversion rate will be enormous because people will not be able to help themselves to find out what's behind this particular offer. Yeah? So then they click I'm in. And then the way I've set it up, I'll show you how I've set it up. But then what it does is they pop the email address in there and it sends them to AdVGO. Okay? So you've collected. What that little process has done there from Facebook, yeah? And again, I'll show you in a minute how I do it and what it does. But it's, when someone clicks that, I've got the Facebook pixel, okay? When they fill in the email, I've got the email. So I can then retarget these people with an autoresponder email campaign for the next, just an example there, I want you guys to test it. And I think I've set it up for the next 5 days, you're going to receive automatically emails about AdVGO. I've collected a Facebook retargeting pixel, which then I do paid ads on Facebook, and then I retarget that particular audience for that particular product or whatever I want to advertise. But basically, I've got that person because they've clicked that banner. I have them for 180 days on my audience from Facebook pixel list, and I've got the email forever. And it's again about building your email list and cross-promoting. So that's what's that accomplished so far. And again, I want you to test this. Eh? As soon as you put that email address in, say, yes, I'm in, you'll receive automatically this email, AdVGO Team Build Early Birds. Eh? Fantastic place to advertise. So you've got them going to AdVGO direct as soon as they press I'm in. Then they'll automatically, you're going to have them directly get an email with another link 2 at VTuo. So if they didn't like it the first time, by the time they get to open that, they may bite the second time. Also, a link for the Facebook group. And also, below you'll find out all our current team build projects at the Early Birds team build, working together, winning together. Let me see. Click that. And this process all starts from that one banner. And that sends them to, this is my page for the products that are advertised, which is always going to be the Early Birds products. And again, you can advertise anything you want in that email, but it's literally a process. And again, it's Early Birds again, and then it's like a huge, huge circular. And for the next 5 days, once you click that banner, put in your email, you're going to get emails from me promoting Ads VTuo. So again, I'll just repeat. Someone's browsing on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, whatever. I make a clickable image. They click the image. They can't help themselves. And I'm going to show you, it's literally 4 hours old. Eh? They'll say, well, what is it about? And if they know, if they leave that page, they know they're never going to know. Curiosity killed the cat and all that. You know, they will put it in, I'm telling you. And then it sends them on the journey. Once they've done the email, it sends them to your AdVGO. I then retarget them for God knows how long, for the next 2 years on whatever I'm pushing at the particular time. But at least for the next 5 days, you're pushing AdVGO to that person. So that gives you a rundown so far. The process of posting an ad, grabbing the Facebook pixel, grabbing the email, sending them to where you want them to go, which is AdVGO in this particular instance, and then retargeting them. You know, if they see the email 5, 6, 7 times, different emails, whatever, eventually they'll click. It's about numbers. It's volume and numbers. Eh? You get one, and again, posting a banner ad on Facebook and posting, you know, in groups. I'm going to be posting this all over, and I'm going to show you over periods how these results are building just from that one post. And I can give you a quick overview. This is the post, what we're talking about. So that's the particular landing page. Again, it's not a fancy landing page. It's nothing special. I use GetResponse, but again, I'm going to go through in the video what different things you can use. Now this, I posted it at 13:58, so that's like, 2 o'clock. It is now 17:49, so it's not even 4 hours. It's had 18 clicks, 18 visits, and it's collected 5 leads. And look at the subscription rate, 27.78%. Now, 18 people have clicked that post. And again, this is brand new. You can see the date, August 18th, 2017, 13:58 is when I made that landing page. And basically, it's a landing page. That's all it is. But it's very basic. No information on it. Get that curiosity. That's what you want. And you want it generic. And I'm going to explain in the video why you want it generic. Not for the program that you're promoting. A lot of people make this mistake. And it's literally, the next thing you do, you have to do this all over again. You know, it's literally, I'm going to show you, it's a very, very powerful time-saving tool. So conversion rate, if anybody can beat that conversion rate, and again, it'll probably go down over time, but 18 people have clicked that banner, and 5 people have signed up with 5 emails. Just for, you know, again, power of collecting to retarget later on. There's just an example there. There's GetResponse. This is, I'll just have a look at Infinity Push. It's only 3. I didn't really push that list. But you can see some of the lists that I've got, but my contacts in GetResponse. Again, I'm quoting GetResponse because this is what I'm using. But you can see 50 Cent Freedom. I set it up, 16 days ago? 112 leads. Coin Impressions, that's something what's coming. I haven't even pushed that yet. It was just like what I posted in Early Birds. Let's Multiply. 566 leads. Now I'm pushing those 566 people to AdVGO. via my email campaigns. And again, that all started off with them clicking a banner on Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, or whatever, grabbing the emails, and then I can promote whatever I want to that. Do I know everybody in that list is either in Let's Multiply or interested because they've signed up to that capture page for that particular program? So I know they're interested in their marketing and making money online. So now, like I said, this list, in this list, 50 Cents Freedom, I'll be promoting AdVies Duo. And I don't have to promote all the time directly to their Facebook page. I just have to send them an email every few days. And again, Hitsmonkey, 500 people. Just about it. And again, it's as you go through, I've got email lists and Traffic Wave, I've got email lists, but I think I'm going to be pulling them all over to get response. I quite like that, the tool. I'm not saying Traffic Wave's bad there, because I've used it a long time and I make good money on Traffic Wave. It's an affiliate program as well. But for this particular instance, I'm going to pause the video, have a cup of coffee, and then I'm going to show you how I got this post on Facebook, how I made it, and I'm going to show you how I made it clickable, and then, you know, in the process. Okay, I've had my cigarette and I've had my coffee, so I'm going to go to the next bit of the video. Now, you might have to pause this video a few times. You might have to re-watch it a few times, but don't worry. I mean, I'm reeling off and I know sometimes I go a little bit fast, but just pause the videos and do everything as a step. So really what you need to do is, and I think what I'll do is I'll make a channel in the Early Birds Media Center, a training channel or something, and then use this video what we're doing now as an introduction, and then do videos for everything in there, you know, one for get response, how to do this, how to do that, one for let's click, and I'll explain in a minute what that is, one for buffer and what have you. But I think this will be the foundation for the training video. So the first thing you've got to do is, and again I'm using get response, but whichever email autoresponder tool that you use, very first step before you do anything, let's just say, right, okay, you're doing an ad video campaign, you have to go over, and again, if you're using a different autoresponder system, it could be different, but email marketing, what you need to do is you need to make yourself a campaign. So an autoresponder campaign, so this is the one that I've just made. Sorry, I was getting distracted there. This is one I've just made. So at the minute I've done AdVies Duo. The status is on, send immediately the date. So what that's the zero means it's going to send as soon as they opt into your capture page, it's going to send it immediately. And then 2 days later, you're going to get the second mail. 4 days later, you're going to get the third mail. And I'll be adding probably about, what I think, another at least 4 mails to that campaign. And probably tomorrow. So everybody who's signed up, 6 people have signed up now. So it's going up. Open rate, look at that. Open rate. So they've got the email. You've got a subscription rate of, what did we say, 37% or something like that. And out of those people, so far, 66% have opened the email, and 50% have clicked the link. And I know, I've already got one sign up. I literally, 15 minutes, 1 second, I have to answer this call. Sorry about that. Okay, so, yeah, there's some guy from Prince Ozzy's trying to phone us, and I don't know what he wants. So where was I? I lost my train of thought there. So I'll add probably another 4 emails to this campaign. So that's the first step. Whatever email capture autoresponder tool that you're using, make your campaign. Then the next thing is you need to make a capture page. And again, get response is good. You can use it just as a email autoresponder tool, and the same with Traffic Wave. And then the next thing you need is a capture page tool. GetResponse has one in there. I think I pay about $19 a month for it. But I'm going to show you guys a cheaper way of doing it, and I'll explain again that there's a lot of information to go through. But you need basically email campaign in your autoresponder tool. If you haven't got an autoresponder tool, give us a shout out, or you can go, and I'm going to put again the link below this video, the early birds, btcearlybirds.com. If you go over there, and I put that link below in the video, click marketing tools, and there you'll see a link for Traffic Wave and a link for Get Response, and also a link for Let's Click and Buffer, and those are the things what you'll need, you know, to do this properly. If you want to do this properly long term and build your email list, you've got to put a little bit of time in it. If you want to just, you know, join the program, spread your links out, fine, you're going to get some results. I'm not saying that's not going to happen, but you want long term, you want long term results, so you've got to set it up. Nothing comes just like that. It's never going to happen. And that's where a lot of people go wrong. They join the program, whatever it is, they get the banners, they throw the banners out, a splash page, they spend all that money on advertising, and then once they're finished, it's just dead. It's dead money. You want to be getting every, like I said in my previous videos, whatever I do something, I get something out of it. Guarantee you, I get something out of it. And a marketer, any online marketer who does it for a living, learns this fast. You've got to get something out of what you're doing. So, going off track again, number one, email list campaign. You need a campaign to send, so you build that. And again, I think this is what I was talking with Tammy about. You know, we're trying to put together an email campaign for Ads V Duo. So when that's finished, we may put the link somewhere, you know, where you can grab it. Or I think in the email, in the file section of the Early Birds, there's actually some in there if you have a look around. Somewhere over capture page. Now again, Get Response has capture page service in there, apart from the the autoresponder service. You need an autoresponder service, whether it's Get Response or Traffic Wave or whatever, whoever, you need that, that's for sure. But then you'll need a capture page service. There's one called Let's Click, and it's a friend of mine. He actually built it. He's an early bird, and he built it together with me and Tammy for us. And if you again, if you go over there, that's the wrong linker. Where is it? Leads Page Plus. I think we'll go over that in another. Where is it? Morgan Tools. Let's Click. There we go. Leads Page Plus. You can join this. I'll just log in. I wasn't ready for that. I forgot about that, to be honest. That's my example. I log in. That's my sponsors banners. When someone joins from my link, they'll see my banners. So it's another, it's like a downline builder before they even start. These, like I said, these are my sponsors, John. That's his links. But when someone joins from my link, they'll see these banners. So before you start, and an intro video, which happens to be Ads V Duo. As you see how the circle builds. So it's about targeting people. And even now I'm doing exactly that in this video. I'm telling you, there's a free version of this. So get yourself in, you can have a play with it. But you'll need to send them to an autoresponder. That you definitely need that. Capture page is another story. But the actual autoresponder, you've got to have that before you go further. So setting up a capture page, I'll show you how I made the one and Get Response. I'll do a video on Let's Click, because again, I've got some good news coming for that. I've been talking to John today, and we're working out a deal to benefit anybody who wants to use it and promote it, because it's all about income streams. And we're nearly there with the deal, and so I'll not go too far into that. So Get Response, and again, I'll not keep saying this, but again, whatever tool you're using as a capture page will be different, maybe, but this is basically the steps. Build yourself an email autoresponder campaign. Then you need to make a capture page. So in this, they call it web forms and surveys. So in this one, create a form, click that, and then again, you've got lots of different tools. You can build it in HTML, you can build it from different apps, but I'll just say I want to use the Let's Build Wizard. And this is all I did for this particular post. Facebook, get responses slow now, I'm recording. I'll just let that work. But this particular, is it my computer or is it get response? I'm not sure. So this particular image you're seeing here came from get response, and typical, it's freezing. Let's have a look. Come on. It's always the same. When I'm recording, my computer just goes bonkers. I don't know why. And it's not that old a computer either. It's like €2,000 I paid nearly for it. So I think I need to clean it. That's half me bother, you know. I think we'll all do that, you know. We'll get the junk downloads and everything. We'll never clean anything. I'm frightened to have a look at the cache, to be honest. Right, there you go. So it's loaded. So I click the Let's Build a Wizard. And there, you see that post there? That's the post or an adaption. So I use that one. So I'm going to click that. Let's say use template. It's very simple. You've got lots of designs in there. But again, capture page, you know, you might not want to use get response. So that was the particular capture page. And literally just change the words. Who wants, you can change it. Let's just say, who wants to, hang on. Let's just get that out of the way. I'll get there eventually. Oh, there we go. So I'll just delete that. Who? Because it's smaller, it's not giving us. Oh, so there we go. I think that might be better. There we go. Who wants to? Smart tips. But just this is an example. You can change the words and the size and the colors, and you can move everything around. But that's just an example. And then we say, okay, we'll use that one. Okay. And then over here, just again, settings, web form, choose a list. Where do you want that? When they've signed that email, where do you want, what list do you want them to go to? So I'm going to say, just an example for this scenario. Let's say AdVGO. That's the list I made for the AdVGO. Confirm opt-in, just say no. You can say yes, but it just sometimes people don't bother, and you know, they move on. So for this particular offer, I would say no. Add to the recycle on the day, and then you can choose which message you want to send. So I'm going to send them the zero message, which sends them directly the message, directly. Choose a thank you page, and this is the important bit. Choose a thank you page, custom. And the thank you page in this particular instance would be, we'll do it. Promotion tools, referrals, just sign up there. I'll do a little update in this video after. So the thank you page will be my referral link for AdVGO. So always remember, choose a list for the form. Choose a thank you page, custom, from the drop-down menu, custom, and then put in your referral link to the offer, in this case, AdVGO. Already subscribed, if they're already subscribed, you know, to that offer, you say, where do you want to send them to? You know, instead, like, say they put in the email, and then they click send, and they're already in your list. You can say send them anywhere to a custom URL and send them again to the offer. Recapture on the second step. I'll just ignore that for now. And then we've got forward and settings and what have you. That's all done. So that's basically what you have to do. So then you click save. So then that's it. And then we'll go over here, save and publish. Okay. And then you need to save and publish it to get the URL. And then, who will publish this form to your website? And you'll say, get, in this particular case, get response. You can copy the code and put it on your own website. Eh? You can put that form anywhere you want. But in this case, I'll say get response. Your form link is blah, blah, blah. So I'll copy that. And I'll explain that bit in a minute. And then basically that you're done. Then you're done, eh? Go to the form list. And we'll see this particular web form. So that's the one we've just made. You can see I've just literally made it now. If you just click it, you can just check that it's that one. See, yes, okay. And now I'm gonna post this in the early birds. I'm gonna post in the early birds. And again, just a test. And I want you just to later on go through the motions. So I'm not gonna post it right now, but before I publish the video to our Facebook room, I'll publish this post. And then you'll understand, and then you can search in the early birds where the post is and click it and go through the motions. And you'll see that this is the post that we're talking about. So that's done. Anybody who signs up to that particular list will then go to, let's just have a quick look, email marketing. No, that's not it. Autoresponders. They'll go to the list I'll just have a quick look. There, I've got all lists. I just want to show you. Where is it? AdV Duo. So, yes, okay. So I just want to see. So that's AdV Duo list. And actually, there I've spotted a mistake straight away. I'll just change that. So I'll say 5 days. So anybody who signs up to that list, you know, that email capture page form, will then start, it'll put the email address in, it'll send them to AdV Duo, and it'll also start sending them emails for the next 5 days. One direct, one 2 days later, one 4 days later, but I might change that to 3, and change that one to 5, and then I'm going to probably add a couple more in. You need about 7. Don't put more than 7 in for a particular sign-up form. Because it, you know, people start seeing it. If they haven't bought it after 7 emails, you know, they're not interested. But again, you've still got the email for other opportunities. Okay, so I hope I'm not going around. Again, you might have to pause it because sometimes my explanations are not the best in the world. Basically, there, you know, we've got the email campaign, which is that, all set up. When you're going to send them, and again, your autoresponder might be different. Got that set up. Then you've got the capture page set up. It could be another capture page, but whatever, it doesn't matter. I'm liking GetResponse more and more. I used them a few years ago, and then the prices started to creep up. You know, me being a penny pincher, I was looking for cheaper things and everything else. But again, I've learned a big lessons in life. You get what you pay for. I always say that free is free. Okay, you get what free is, gets your foot in the door and helps you start to learn. If you want to get good results and good tools and no rubbish and there's no banners anywhere, you see there's no advertisements or anything, you get what you pay for. So I'm sort of pulling my way back over to GetResponse, to be honest. So you've got those two things, email list, capture page. Then what you want to do is, this is what I did, I forgot that bit. Whatever. Go back to my forms. Then what I did is, and I'm going to do it with this one. Again, just ignore this in the early birds. This is just an example. I took this and I screenshotted. And this is where I seen a post by Kevin Cowley. Yeah? How did you do this? So then what I did was I just took a screenshot of that. Okay. And that's it. We're done. So I took the screenshot. Now we'll get to the bit is, how do you make this image clickable? Sorry if I go off topic here, I had to pause my video, somebody needed this for something. So we've done the email campaign, we've done the autoresponder section, and then now I'm going to show you how to make the picture clickable. You can do it other ways. You can post, you know, your link out there for your capture page and just, you know, hope someone clicks your link. But clickable images, I'm telling you, you get massive conversions on them. And I use a tool called Let's Click. I think it's called Let's Click. And again, you can find it from the link below I'm not going to put loads of links in there, but if you watch the link and click marketing tools, click let's click. You click that tool, it costs money. Same as, you know, if you want the tools, you have to pay for them. Simple as that. But once you've got them, this tool is absolutely fantastic. I'm loving it. I've used it for a few months now and I'm absolutely loving it for a number of reasons. Now remember I said when they click that image, the first thing I've got is the Facebook pixel. And we'll cover that in a whole video later down the road. But you want that Facebook pixel. So this is the link that I've made. And it's had 22 clicks. So that click on Facebook, I wish this guy... I'm going to strangle Kevin Cowley if he doesn't stop texting us because it keeps popping up on my screen. So this post we're looking at here is this post, and it's been clicked 22 times. And again, you can see when I made it, when I posted it, and I can also see from this tool, let's click, it gives us quite, you know, if you click report, I'll just log in. It gives us stats, and I can see, you know, all what browsers they're using, how much mobile devices against desktop, and normally desktop always wins. A lot of people think mobile wins, but it doesn't. I track my stats on videos and everything, and I know it's normally 75-25% ratio to desktop. And then from the stats, again, it's only a couple hours old, 4 hours old. I've had 4 clicks in Canada, 4 in the United States, 7 in the United Kingdom, 1 in Nepal, 1 in Bangladesh, Philippines 2, Australia 2. You know, it gives you, there you go, it gives you the country list, so you don't have to get hover around it. But this is just 4 hours old. And I've just got a little bit off topic. I'll pull a post with a little bit higher numbers. So there, that one, jointheseprograms.com. 99 clicks, and if I click the report, it gives us a lot of valuable information. These are the timed hours they clicked it, and that's telling me between 11, this is based on my time, you'll see different results in yours, but that's telling me between 11 and 12 my time, it's getting the highest amount of clicks, and the lowest amount you can see there. So when I'm doing my scheduling in Buffer or in this tool, that gives us an idea when to say to schedule it there, because these three times at the minute, between 11 and 12, between 10 at night and 11 at night, and between midnight and 1 in the morning, which is probably about right because America starts kicking in at that time of the world, that time zone, shall we say. But that's just one tool that what people should, you know, use. And then that's the daily clicks. Again, the browser information. You can drive yourself crazy looking at this, but what is very important is showing you where you're getting the clicks from. And if you're doing any targeting lists, you know, later on down the road, paid email campaigns or paid advertising banners, and you can pick where do you want to send them. Looking at this, that tells me straight away, okay, United States is good, Canada's good, United Kingdom's good, Belgium probably, actually no, because it's tracks your IP, so that's Belgium's quite good as well. And then you can see here Ireland, Australia, Russia. So if you're spending money on targeting specific parts of the world, these tools over time give you a lot of information on where to send these paid ads, you know, targeted ads. But that again, that's just going off topic. So we'll go back to this post, what we're talking about. So, and then I cloned the post. So I posted that direct. And then this one, I've cloned it. And again, we'll do another video of how to do all of that. But I've scheduled it, the clone poster. So this is the post that and I did it via Buffer. And again, Buffer is in this list. Marketing tools, Buffer. And there's help and setup, Buffer. There's help and setup Leads Page Plus. And I'll probably do some more as we go on, you know. To be honest, I was a bit overwhelmed with how do you do this, how do you do that. I had my hands full and I really didn't expect so many questions. But we'll get there, I'm sure of it. So let's click go back there. So this is the two, that's the one I posted, and this is the one I've scheduled. So you can see there I've posted time 18th of the 8th, and that's there. That's the first one I've posted, and this one's going to go out later tonight, Brussels time, at 11 p.m. So that's what time you'll see that in the Facebook group of the early birds, because I've scheduled it to go in there. But I'm going to set up a clickable link for the post we just did for that campaign, what we set up. So what I'll do is I'll go over here, click new link, and then you can either browse. There's some, in this particular software, there's some smashing images already, but I'm going to upload an image. And you've got two choices, drag it in or upload an image or select from a URL, what's on Facebook or whatever, or Google or wherever. If you see a nice image, you can copy the URL of that image and drag it in here. But I'm going to select it from uploads because that's the screenshot, remember? No, it's not. Oh, no, sorry. Upload an image. And then click there. And then we'll look for the image that I just screenshotted, which was that one. And remember this. Now it says the image has got... Now I'm glad it's done that because I wanted to go through this. Image must be at least 400 by 400. And it's not there. So I'll remove that file. And then I'll open a new tab. And again, I think I'll put this link because I use this all the time. And I'm going to add this actually to the Early Birds team build page. This resize pick is a free tool and I use it literally, I think, every single day. Every day. It's a free tool, resizepick.com. And again, I'll put that link below. So you'll have BTC Early Birds and resize pick. Choose the file. So where's the image that I just screenshotted? So I have to find it first. That's that one, I think. So we say choose that file. And then now I want to say change it. So I'm going to say let's make it 600 by 400. Remember, it's got to be 400, at least 400 by 400 to put it in. Let's click. So then we're going to resize the image. And that's basically, you know, this will make no sense to anybody. This is only going to go on the early birds. It's just an example. Okay, it looks okay. And then you just click download. Click that. Downloads the image. And then we're done with that. That's finished. I'm glad that did that actually, because Resize Pick is a really, really valuable tool. It's free, like I said, it's free. Then we'll go back to upload an image. Click. And then we'll go to downloads, because I've just downloaded that new image. And there's that new image today, 1840. So I'll just click that one and open it. And this time, it's fine. And then we'll say done. So there's the image, and that's what it's going to look like on Facebook or Twitter or whatever. Destination URL, and this is the important bit. And you might pause this and think, you know, pause the video, grab a coffee or whatever. Destination URL is the capture page that I just made in GetResponse. Or in your case, it could be TrafficWave or it could be another autoresponder. Capture page tool, sorry. So that's the URL. What I'm going to link the image to. Okay. So basically when this is images on Facebook and then they click the image, it's going to send them to my web capture page. Okay. And then you put that in there. That's fine. And then you go choose a domain name. Just leave that. Choose, let's click domain name. In here you've got different offers. You see there where it says subscribe me now at. Now we don't want to say that because it puts them off. I always like to say let's look at. And you see now it changes to let's look at. And then the subdomain. For this one, what can I say? Sorry, the custom link. Let's just say early birds test. Because remember this is not going anywhere else. Early birds test. There you go. So now it's going to show early birds test. Let's look at. Doesn't tell them that, oh, watch out, I'm about to grab your email address or your pixel list. So, you know, keep it friendly so that it doesn't put them off clicking. And then you can group it in this particular software that I use. You can make groups. So BTC Early Birds, that was another group I made, JV Zoo Products and whatever. So I'll group it to BTC Early Birds. And again, pixel list. In this particular program, when you're setting it up, you can put your Facebook pixel list in here one time. And you can put more than one in there. But in this case, add pixel list and drop down menu, I chose, it's actually called Let's Click, but I just use the same pixel list for a lot of programs. So, and then create, forgot one thing, headline. You've got to put a headline in there, and I'm just going to call this Early Birds Test. Create link. Now there you go, the link's created. You can post it now directly to Facebook. If you don't want to go through the buffer zone, which I would not recommend to miss out, short term you can just post it directly to Facebook, but the buffer, get involved with that, because you can once you've set your buffer up and put your details of buffer in this software, you can schedule the buffer direct from here. But for argument's sake, for now, for quickness, I'm going to post it now to Facebook. You click that. We'll get the thing popping up, and it, you know, as we normally do. So that's what, just ignore the gray area, it's not going to be there. So where do I want to post it? I want to post it to a group, and let's say in this particular case, the early birds. And then, I'll post it now. So when you'll see this video very soon, and just look for this post in the early birds. So post to the Facebook. And it's done. Close. And then we'll just nip back over to here and just have a look, just to be sure. So there it is. Yeah. So that's the post that I've just done. The headline, where it's going to send them to. The post, and where it's going to send them to. Sometimes, you know, if you copy this. Copy the link to the post. There's another shortcut I do. Instead of sharing everything, sharing the groups. Yeah? Sometimes if you want to just go to the group, or just nip over to Facebook. I'll do it once there, because someone's going to wonder what the hell we're doing. Let's just say I go to Internet Marketing Kings. I've copied the URL from this post. Yeah? And you can paste that in there. Let the image show. Then delete the URL. And that's what's going to show up. And I'll just post it once, just for fun. It's going to send them the ad videos list in any way. But normally I wouldn't be posting that all over the place. For this video, I'm just posting direct with the early birds. So we'll go back. We'll go now into the early birds. I know there's a lot to take in this video, but I think I'll do videos for each particular program as well. But I just wanted to give you an outline of how I do it. Yeah? From start to finish. And if you people say, oh, your video is too long and whatever, if you're not interested, if you can't concentrate on an hour, then you should not be internet marketing, that's for sure. If you're not willing to, a lot of people are click happy and they just want everything instantly. It's never going to happen. Eh? So there's the post. So you can see that it's 1 minute ago. Jim Watts shared the link. You watched us do it on the video, so there's no words, there's no, you can pick any image you want. This is the beauty of that programmer. Lovely image, people are going to click it. So take this particular case, they click the video, click the image. Where does it send them? To the URL, which is the landing page, what I made in GetResponse. You put in the email address, and for this sake we'll put in there, I'm in. And remember the thank you page? What you put in, get response, and again, it could be any autoresponder, takes them to wherever you want them to send, program that you're offering it. And it also grabs the email, and that person, whoever's just clicked that banner, is then automatically on my autoresponder list for that campaign. And they're going to get 5 to 7 emails over the next, say, 10 days about AdVGO. Okay? So that's... I know there's probably a lot to take in, and there's a lot to digest and what have you, but That's the way it is. Eh? We'll just quickly go over here and just see if we've got any changes. Dashboard. And where were contacts? Where's my contacts? They've just changed the back office as I'm finding my way around it. Eh? So there you go. Early birds. There's another one. 6. And then, so just have a quick look at that. Actually, I think there's the people who signed up already. And again, I'm going to cloud this out. But you can see, and it also shows you, both at, like tomorrow or the day after, it shows what autoresponder letters they've received. So they've received the 01, which has been in direct in a couple of days. I'm going to do these videos, you know, as update videos, should we say, and just show you how this is going to build it. But you'll see what stage of that campaign they've received the letters and where did they come from as well, the origin. IP address, I'm going to cloud that out in the emails, you know, I don't want to be showing emails to everybody. So I hope that gives you a little bit of an idea. Yeah. So just as a little recap, clickable image, click the image, landing page, email capture page, landing page I call it, grab the email address, click the link after the, if you try and do it before, it says, sorry, email is invalid, eh? You've got to put an email in. And believe me, they'll 9 times out of 10, they'll click it just to have a look. I'm telling you. Thank you page, important, send them to whatever program that particular capture page is about. And again, I mentioned right at the beginning of the video, about saving. Now, that's just an example. I'm posting all over the internet. Who wants some Bitcoin? You know, this, I'm posting all over the internet, this post, not that one, obviously, this post. In 6 months' time, that post's still all over the internet, eh? It's still all over Facebook, it's still over YouTube, it's still over paid marketing, what I've done. Now, let's just say that I want to push for 1 week a different program. I couldn't tell you where all my posts are, and you couldn't. And this is the method I use again with me rotator, but let's just say this is all over the internet in a few months, but I want for 1 week promote something else, build another list, promote something else. All I have to do is, and again, this is where I like get response, go to the forms. Okay. This is the form, what we're talking about here. And then I'll edit the form. And then all I have to do is, and this is the magic, you can change the settings of the form. Okay, so the form, it's still the same form name. Which list do I want to send it to? I can make a new list, you know, against the new product what I'm promoting for the week. And then I put in a new thing, choose the thank you page custom and send them to whichever page, whatever I'm promoting at the time. Eh? And then I would go off again and, you know, aggressively promote that particular banner. But what it also does, and then you just click save. I'm not going to do that, but then you click, well, actually, I can because I didn't change anything. And then what that does is, that banner, what you've posted all over the place, the URL is exactly the same. It just takes them to a different, because you've just changed your settings in here. It takes them to a new email. It grabs the email and puts them in a new list, whichever one you want. And it sends them to a new promotion, you know, whatever that particular product you're promoting for the week. You don't have to go around the whole world on the internet and remember where you put all the banners and everything, and all the banners you posted like 3 months ago are still valid. So if someone just stumbles upon your post, and it happens all the time, I promise you, it happens all the time. I get people saying enough of programs like I was promoting 6 months ago, but it's sort of, if you do it like this, all those banners that are lying around all over the internet are still valid. You just change from the you get response, or again, whatever program they're using, the thank you page, the, you know, the forwarding page, because it, again, it's a generic banner. You're not saying AdVJuvo on here. The only sort of limit you've got on this one, I suppose, is Bitcoin. Yeah, but if if you see that banner, it's not telling. So when they click it, put the email in, you haven't already told them what the program is, so they're not going to be disappointed to get sent to a different offer. If you have AdVJoe all over this banner, and then 6 months down the road, you change the direction of where you want to send them after they've entered the email, and it sends them to a dog grooming website, they're going to be upsetter. So you've got to be careful. You know, that's why generic banners are very, very important for this particular method. There's lots of different methods of marketing, but this is how I get results. People say to me, how do you get so many signups? How do you get so many signups in such a short time? And the reason is collecting the emails from other programs, other offers, stocking them in my autoresponder campaigns. And then when, you know, program comes out, I make a quick banner, bang, send it to the email list. I can get 10, 15 signups within an hour. Just, I do it all the time, I promise you. Over time, it takes time. There's no magic solution out there, and I see a lot of people getting frustrated. No spillover. Like, I'll just quickly go over to AdVJoe. We're coming to 50 minutes, and I want to keep it to an hour. AdVJoe. And they get upset. You know, why? How you got these results? And because I work my backside off and doing what I'm showing you. And if you don't take any notice, and probably 90% of the people who watch this video will not follow through. But the same 90% are screaming, oh, I don't make any money online, and it's you know, a scam and blah, blah, blah. It's not. It's about how to do it. Everybody has their own version. This is my version, and it's working for me. AdVJoe, it's not, what, I don't know how long it is now, maybe 8 days or something. And I've had people complaining already, no spillover. It takes time to build it. I've spent $105. I've received $440. But I'm going to receive a lot more. And I'm sure a lot of my team, you know, in the early birds team will. And you can see here, there's still one spot. I don't know what it is about this one spot. People are joining. And then, you know, how the system kicks you out. And it keeps popping back. It shows 25, 26, 27. But that one person, I'm just trying to fill. I'm trying to fill that one spot. And then that's completely full. So, you know, I'm promoting my link, they're promoting theirs, they're promoting theirs, and it's all dropping down now into this level. And then my level 4, 42 people, 105 people paid in a week, just over a week. Who can tell, you know, people who've been doing this a long time, that's only people who can do that. And this is how I do it. So if people think, oh, it doesn't work, or he's talking rubbish, I kind of be more transparent than what I'm showing you. And I promise you, it takes time, like I said. And this AdVJoe, don't let what I've said there put you off, because this is going to spill. It's going to snowball. It's going to snowball massive. I know it is. And then you've got 50 Cents Freedom, quick update. I noticed there was an update in the back office there now. And I quite like that. That's just, if you give it a read there, but what she's doing is she's showing you the progress of each, what's happening timetable. So now, just an example, adding, depositing back into accounts in progress. Then the next stage, you know, people like to see what's going on instead of a blank screen, should we say. It's getting there. But again, this program is an email building list tool all day long, I've got, like, literally all these I made downline. I'm taking the emails, I'm copying them like this, putting them on a sheet, and then I'm importing them to my autoresponder campaign. I've got them all day. Money fund out. And I'll sell to that list, not just 50 cents. I'll sell AdVJoe, I'll sell JVZoo products, I'll sell Early Birds, you know, I'll sell loads of things to them. And it all starts with, just to recap, one clickable post. Okay, right, we're 54 minutes, plenty to get through. Don't get overwhelmed, because there's a lot to take in, and I know I sometimes forget, you know, I click away and I talk away, so everybody's on the same, you know, timeline as I am. But I'm telling you, this marketer, and watch out, Jamie will probably not mind saying this, there's marketers out there, big marketers who don't really haven't gone down the email route yet. They make YouTube videos. That's another way, you know, it's another path of marketing. It's a bloody powerful one. But when you combine those two together, video and collecting the emails, just think about that. Yeah? There's a lot of potential. Okay, I'll not waffle. Have a great weekend. I'm not making any videos this weekend. I'm going to have a pizza in 1-2 hours, I think. It's getting delivered. And it's 1 o'clock time. Jim's having the night off. Okay. So enjoy your weekend, everybody. And below the video, I'll put BTC Early Birds. And there you'll find all the links to what I'm talking about. And I'll stick in that resize one, because that's a bloody excellent tool. And it's absolutely free. You can check. You've got to look at that and bookmark them. And will you all do us a favor as well? Pop over. I'm going to put this in the Early Birds via YouTube. Pop over to the YouTube and give it a thumbs up and subscribe, because this advances again in YouTube. It's like Facebook when you like and comment. YouTube, subscribe and like. Give it a thumbs up and even give it a comment if you want, yeah, but nothing bad, nothing nasty. Yeah? And it helps build up your profile in YouTube. Same as Google Plus. If you see a post in Google Plus, give it one of those plus tickets. It's the equivalent of a like. Yeah? I do it for me. If I see anybody who I know on Google Plus, it's half of them. I'm not even in the programs. I just give them a plus. And I hope they give me a plus back. And it literally helps as a team build. Yeah, remember, we're all in the same team. Eh? Helps boost. Okay. Right. Have a good weekend. Catch you later.